Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, previously we have seen how to do analysis in case of composite cylinder and we have solved one problem based on that. Let us solve one more problem on the same topic. In this problem, that is number 2 on composite cylinder, the question was asked in May 11 in case of Mumbai University. The question says, the hot gas at 325 degrees Celsius flows through a metal pipe 10 cm OD. So the outer diameter is given as 10 cm and 3 mm thick. So the thickness of the pipe is given as 3 mm. It is insulated with a mineral wool in such a way that the insulation temperature should not exceed 50 degrees Celsius. So the pipe which is carrying a steam hot gas at 325 degrees Celsius is insulated with the mineral wool, and they are saying that the outside temperature should not be more than the 50 degrees Celsius. For that condition, they are asking us to determine the thickness of insulation taking following data. The data that they have given is HI, that is the heat transfer coefficient for the inside gas, is given as 25 watt per meter square Kelvin. HO, that is for the outside air, they have given this as 10 watt per meter square Kelvin. The ambient temperature, that is the temperature of air, they have given as 25. Thermal conductivity, K for the metal pipe is given as 40 watt per meter Kelvin. Then K for mineral wool, they have given as 0.045 watt per meter Kelvin. Also calculate the loss of heat per meter after putting the insulation. So once the insulation is there, then what is the loss of heat? That is Q dash is what they are asking us to find out. So let us start solving this problem. Now here we have shown in the schematic diagram, this red color is a pipe. Let's say the inside radius is Ri, outside radius is R2, and then there is a insulation shown by the dotted line over here. Let us say the insulation radius is R3. Then let us write down what all things that they are given. The pipe is containing hot gases whose temperature is 325. So let's say the T gas is a 325. Then diameter is given as 100 mm. From that we can deduce that the value of R2, that is the outer radius, is 50 mm. Similarly, they have given the thickness as 3 mm. So R1 is 47 mm. T3, that is the temperature at the outer surface of the insulation, is 50 degrees Celsius is what they have given. Then the air temperature TA, that is the outside air temperature, is what they have given as 25 degrees Celsius, this one here. Then the value of thermal conductivity of the pipe KP is 40 watt per meter Kelvin. The value of thermal conductivity of the mineral wool is, let's say, KM, which is given as 0.045 watt per meter Kelvin. Similarly, the value of HI, that is the heat transfer coefficient for the inside gases, they have given this as 25 watt per meter square Kelvin. The value of H0 is 10 watt per meter square Kelvin is what they have given us. Now they are asking us to find out that what should be the value of R3 so that the T3 reaches to 50 degrees Celsius. That is the first thing. And second thing is they are asking us to find out the value of heat transfer rate, that is the Q dash, that is the heat loss through this pipe. Now, before solving this problem, one must write down the assumptions. As we had seen last time around, the assumption in this case is also same. That is, first is the conduction and convection is only considered, radiation is neglected. Second one is the heat transfer is only radial direction. So the heat transfer through phi and z direction is neglected. Third one is no heat generation. Fourth one, the heat transfer is steady state. Fifth one, the thermal conductivity is constant. So K is constant. With the help of this assumption, we can deduce the general equation to the simplified one, and then we can solve the given problem. Now, on the same problem, let us start drawing first of all the thermal circuit diagram. The outside temperature they had given is the, let's say, TG, that is the gas temperature. Then from there, there will be a resistance offered by the gases. So let me call this as RHI, and temperature is, let's say, T1. Then the thermal resistance will be offered by the pipe itself. So let me call this as RKP. The intermediate temperature is, let's say, T2. Then there will be a resistance offered by the insulation. Let us call that as RKM. And the temperature in this case is, let's say, T3, which they have given as 50 degrees Celsius. Then finally, the resistance offered by the ambient air. So let us call this as RHO. And then the final temperature is, let's say, TA. So now let us square those temperature which are known to us. See, in this case, they have given this temperature as 325 degrees Celsius. They have given this temperature as 50 degrees Celsius. And they have given this temperature as 25 degrees Celsius. Now, as I've told you before, that the heat transfer rate through this node will be same no matter which nodes you are considering. So if the heat transfer is, let's say, Q dash, it will be same from TG to T3 and from T3 to TA. So now let us do the same thing. Let us equate the heat transfer rate through TG to T3 and from T3 to TA. So let us write down the value of Q dash, that is the heat transfer rate. First of all, write down the delta T, that is between the TG and T3. Now, from this diagram, you can make out that there are three resistances which we need to consider: RHI, RKP and RKM for this node. And in second case, there is only one resistance, that is RHO. So let us write down those resistance. First one is RHI, then RKP, and then RKM. So this we will equate with the final node, that is T3 minus TA upon the resistance here is only RHO. Now in this case, let us substitute the numbers. Before substituting the numbers, let us write down the various resistance. So RHI in this case is 1 upon HI, and the area is obviously 2 pi R1 into L. Now here we will consider the value of L as 1. The thermal resistance offered by the pipe is ln of R2 upon R1 upon 2 pi LKP. Similarly, the resistance offered by the wool is ln of R3 by R2 upon 2 pi LKM. And the thermal resistance offered by air is again 1 upon HO. The area is 2 pi R3 into length L. Now in this equation, the only unknown that we are having is R3. Now let us start putting the numbers. So the value of TG is 325. This is 50 upon 1 upon the value of HI is 25. What we can do in this case is this 2 pi can be taken out common and it can be cancelled out, and we can write down that the value of L in this case is 1. So that also can be neglected. So in this case, the only unknown will be HI and R1. So HI is given, which is 25, and R1 is given as 0.047. Now the value of R2 is 50 and R1 is 47. Now since I told you before that this is a ratio, so no need to convert this into meter. Upon the value of KP is 40 plus here ln of R3 upon 50 divided by the value of KM is 0.045. This is equal to, again, this temperature difference, that is T3, which is 50, minus TA, which is 25, is what they have given, divided by 1 upon HO, which is 10. 2 pi is cancelled out and L is 1, so only unknown is R3. Now in this entire equation, the only parameter which is not known is R3. So if we start solving this, then we should get the value of R3. So if we keep solving like this, finally we will get the value of R3 by trial and error method. See, why trial and error method? Because in one equation, the R3 is there in the logarithmic term and here it is there in the algebraic form. So in one case, it is in logarithmic form and in other case, it is in algebraic form. So we cannot linearly solve this equation. We have to solve this by trial and error. And finally, we get to the answer as R3 is equal to approximately 86 mm. This is just the first part of our solution. Now let us go for the second one. See, as I told you before, Q dash can also be given as T3 minus TA upon 1 upon H0 2 pi R3L. Now here we have considered the third and the final node of the temperature. So let us put the numbers. T3 is 50 minus 25 divided by 1 upon, the value of H0 is 10 into 2 pi. The value of R3 is 86 into 10 raised to minus 3 and the L is 1. So if I start solving this, then the number should be around 43. So finally, we get the value of Q dash as 43 pi into 10 raised to 6 watt per meter. So you can substitute the value of pi as 22 by 7 and get to the final answer. Now that is it in this problem. Here we have tried to find out the limiting value of R3 and then what is the loss of heat, that is the value of Q dash, with the knowledge of composite cylinder. Thank you for watching this video. Please stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda. Thank you.